Morning, guys. Yeah, so we've been here at Gist Creek Marina all morning long, and I've actually heard from many people that this is a great lake to come and fish on. So now we're talking with a couple fish biologists, and first up we have David over here. David, you've already been out here pulling some fish for us this morning, right?
Oh, yeah. We went out. We want to give you a little taste test of what we got here. So this is a largemouth bass lake, primarily a lot of 2 to 5 pound bass we have in the lake. We also nice crappie population, and flathead and channel catfish are doing pretty good too.
You want to show us some of what you've already gotten this morning?
Yeah, absolutely.
How big are these bass that we're talking about? How big is this one that you got this morning?
So this fish here is probably going to be about a 4 pound fish. It's probably about an 18-19 inch largemouth. So this is a very common fish we have here. I mean, we have a lot of people come out here. We do a lot of tournaments, a lot of catfishing. We also stock hybrid striped bass here annually. So probably is low numbers, but if you want to catch one over 10 pounds, this is a good place
to give it a shot.
Absolutely.
As you put that fish back in, tell me some other places locally that are good fishing spots for people.
So obviously Gist Creek, but I'd also push Taylorsville Lake if you're in the Louisville area. The crappie population is doing phenomenal. We've had some good spawns, a lot of fish over the 10 inch size limit right now, so it's getting heavily used, but I would recommend going and giving it a shot.
All right, well, we're looking at this boat too that they are using with what I'm going to call contraptions, and Jeff, I've got you over here to explain to me exactly what you do as a fish biologist and how this works.
Yeah, this is an electrofishing boat. This is one of the pieces of equipment we use to sample fish. It puts electricity in the water, and that's what these wires are for. Electricity comes into the water, stuns the fish. We're able to collect those fish, put them in the live well there, and do a quick assessment, and get them back in the water, back in the lake, so fishermen can catch them.
And what is the purpose of that for Kentucky waterways?
It allows us to monitor the populations over a period of time. We've been doing this for many years, so we're able to follow trends in those fish populations. And so that kind of helps us determine regulations or stocking needs or any other, whatever needs to be done management-wise for the fish.
All right, well, I would say it's a pretty good day to come out here and fish before the weather comes in, guys. It feels so good out here. Coming next, we're going to talk about fishing licenses, how old you have to be to have one, and then also parents, how you can take your kids fishing without having one.